Hello all. So far we have studied about the section of solids and development of surfaces. So now we are going to study about a new topic which is known as the perspective projection, right? So we have studied about the projection of solids, orthographic projection, right? In orthographic projection, an object is placed at infinity or the observer is at infinity so that the visual rays coming from the eye of the observer will be parallel to the ground so that every object can be seen as it's a front view, top view, like that. Okay, for example, if this is a rectangular block, if it is an orthographic projection, since the observer is at infinity, the visual rays coming from the eye of the observer will be parallel to the ground, so that this can be seen only as a rectangle, right? This portion can be only seen as a rectangle. But in actual practice, the observer will be placed at a finite distance, so that when he or she is observing an object from a finite distance, suppose he is observing from here, he can see this portion, this portion, this portion, some portion about this, okay, so that he can observe these portions. But if he is at infinity, he can only see this. That's the difference between orthographic projection and perspective projection. So perspective projection is a parallel projection where the observer is at a finite distance, right? Okay, now in orthographic projection, we have studied about, we have learned that there is a horizontal plane, this ground, or this one is an HP, and there is a vertical plane, VP. Right. But in perspective projection, this horizontal plane or HP is known as a ground plane. So this is a ground plane. There is no vertical plane. That plane is called picture plane. That plane is called picture plane. Picture plane is the point where the object is can be projected or is seen. For example, if we are taking, suppose this is an object, and if this is a digital camera, and if we are taking a photo of this one, this object can be seen as an image on the screen, right? So at that point, this can be taken as a picture plane. Okay, you know that if this is an object, and when we are taking a photographic photograph by putting the screen here, the image of the object will be smaller than the original image, right? So this is a perspective projection. Here this is a picture plane. So this is a ground plane, this is a picture plane. One more plane is there. See, the eye of the observer, eye of the observer is called a station point. Eye of the observer is known as a station point, SP. So the visual rays coming from the eye of the observer pierces at points on the picture plane so that that can be connected to obtain our image. Now there is a plane like this. That plane is perpendicular to both the ground plane and the picture plane and passing through the eye of the observer. This plane is known as a central plane. So this plane is known as a central plane. So the three planes on a perspective projections are ground plane, picture plane, and central plane. Okay. Then there is one more plane which is called plane like this. That plane is a parallel to ground plane and passing through the eye of the observer. That is known as a horizon plane. That is called a horizon plane. Okay. Now, usually for easy, perspective projections are projected in third angle projection. So in first angle projection, we know that front view is in the top of the XY line, top view is placed in the bottom of the XY line. In third angle projection, front view is in the bottom and or below the XY line, and top view is above the XY line. In perspective projection, the usual practice is following the third angle projection, which means the front view will be below the XY line and the top view will be above the XY line. Okay, so in perspective projection, there is a ground plane, there is a picture plane PP, there is a ground plane GP, there is a central plane which is perpendicular to both HP, both the ground plane and the picture plane, and passing through the station point. Station point means eye of the observer, and it is called central plane. Okay, then there is one more plane which is called plane like this. That plane is a parallel to ground plane and passing through the eye of the observer. That is known as a horizon plane. That is called a horizon plane. Okay, so ground plane, picture plane, horizon plane, and central plane. Now you can understand the perspective projection by doing a problem. Okay, so next we are going to a problem. I hope you have understood the basics of perspective projection.